since the community college started. Before I make some formal remarks, the governor is going to start by reading a proclamation to everyone. But when you think about this day and here at the State House, I mean, the connections between Governor Chafee and the Governor Chafee who established us, John Chafee, 50 years ago, is why the community college is where it is today. He established us. Chafee Boulevard on our Newport campus, and Governor Lincoln Chafee has carried on that wonderful tradition because he's been an incredible supporter of higher education. And we all know that his term is up, and he'll be leaving us in about a month or so. But more importantly, on behalf of all of us at the Community College of Rhode Island, let's give our governor a round, big round of CCRI.
Right. It's great to continue the legacy of my dad, who started the junior college, Rhode Island Junior College, back when he was governor 50 years ago. So it's great to be here with the elected officials. And when I think about what made America great, more than anything after World War II and the GI Bill and people coming back and the baby boom, it was our higher education public institutions that really made this country the greatest country in the world, from the URIs and the junior colleges and the investment the states were making into these public institutions of higher education. So unfortunately, during the downturn of the economy, our public institutions of higher education kind of took it on the chin, the cuts, just with the downturn of the economy. But I was determined to reverse that coming in, despite having to raise the revenue elsewhere. But I always thought that's the best place to make our investments in these great institutions. And CCRI, happy birthday. Got four whereases. Whereas Community College of Rhode Island is the largest public two-year degree granting college in New England. Who knew that? Providing a variety of career, technical, and academic programs at four main campuses in Warwick, Lincoln, Providence, and Newport. A little bit in Westerly, Mr. President? A little bit Westerly. Gotta get that in here. What's that, five? Oh, here we go. In a secondary Providence campus. In the Shepherd Building in a satellite facility in Westerly. Whereas in January 1960, the Rhode Island Junior College State System was established by an act of the Rhode Island General Assembly and closely followed the recommendation of a commission to study higher education, which called for the establishment of a statewide system of junior college campuses with facilities in the Patuxent Valley, Blackstone Valley, and Mount Hope areas of Rhode Island. And whereas, from its modest beginning with 325 students in 1964 to its present enrollment of almost 18,000 students, Community College of Rhode Island has grown to meet the goals of its founders. And whereas in every sense, Community College of Rhode Island strives to be Rhode Island's community college, meeting the educational needs of the people of this state, now therefore, as governor of the state of Rhode Island, I do hereby proclaim November 12th, 2014 as CCRI Day in Rhode Island.
As the governor said, almost 18,000 students. If you think about that, 18,000 students a semester, about 4,000 in the summer. We also train another 30,000. When you think about that, that's close to 70,000 Rhode Islanders who go through the halls of the community college each and every day. I'd like to start by thanking Governor Chafee for declaring the CCRI Day and for being such a great friend to the college over the course of his time in office. And when the governor took over, you may have known this, we have been stagnant for years, and in fact had more than a 30% reduction in higher education funds. One of the very first thing he did was restore funding. He continued to do it throughout his tenure, and as they say, he spoke, you know, the right words, and he put the money where it needed to go, back into higher education. Governor Chafee, throughout your term, everyone will remember you as the education champion for this state. Thank you so very much. And again, to all our honorary chairs and our governor and all of our elected officials here, it's quite amazing that we're all here together to celebrate. 50 years ago, Governor John Chafee and the state legislators had the vision to bring the community college system to the state of Rhode Island. Community colleges represented opportunity, a chance for everyone, no matter where you came from, no matter how much money your family had or didn't have, to further their education. For many, it was the first that anyone in their family had ever attended college. For many, it was a way out, a chance to better themselves and their family's future. 50 years later, community colleges across the country still represent the same opportunities. Affordability, accessibility, open access to all, and a quality education has always been and remains our true mission. Take a look at CCRI today. As we said, we started with 325 students and 11 faculty members in an old mill building on Promenade Street in 1964. We've grown to nearly 18,000 students, making us the largest community college in New England and over 1,200 employees. We have four campuses, as you've already heard. We are truly, truly Rhode Island's college. We are proud of more than 64,000 alum, most of all who live here in Rhode Island. We're proud to provide workforce training to over 30,000 Rhode Islanders a year. And a number of the state's leading employers continually hire our students. We're proud to provide Rhode Island with more health care workers than any other college in the state. And we're proud to have answered the call on Rhode Island's resurgence to have manufacturing sector with a new dedicated space, new programs, and state-of-the-art equipment. Our student body is the most diverse in the entire state. This fall, nearly 37% of our students self-identify as minorities, and we represent over 100 countries from around the world that attend our community college. We are graduating, just as important, we are graduating more students than ever before. The past 2 years, we saw more than 2,000 students receive degrees and certificates, the most ever. We are also transferring more students than ever before. Some of you have attended our graduations. You have heard some of the most inspiring stories from our students that you will ever hear at any college. Students who grow up living in cars, students who fled war-torn countries, students who attend a class while working two jobs and caring for sick parents. The list goes on and on and on. I'd like to think that it's who CCRI is and what CCRI represents, an opportunity and a chance where none had previously existed, a promise that perseverance can pay off. Barbara Mancuso, a United States Senator from Maryland, said, and I quote, "Community colleges are one of America's great social inventions, a gateway to the future for the first-time students looking for an affordable college education and for mid-career students looking to get ahead in the workplace." And President Barack Obama, who has made the community colleges a high priority, and I quote, has said, "With a changing economy, no one has lifetime employment. But community colleges provide lifetime employability." Those two quotes succinctly sum up what CCRI has been over the past 50 years and what CCRI will be going forward. I don't know what we'll look like in 50 years, but it'll be pretty amazing to think about it. How many, as we bury the time capsule, we had a young man come up who was 18 years old, and I said to him, 50 years from now, I need you to come back here and stand here. And how old will you be? And he thought for a minute, oh my God, 68. And I go, well, you know. So you think about that, 50 years from now, what will we look like? And we know that the community college will be bigger, will be stronger, and still providing and leading the way for economic development in this state. So today it is truly a privilege to stand here as the president of this college. And I truly say that. It's an honor and it's a privilege to represent this school. I can think of no finer place to be. I can think of no finer place to be today than standing here and say, I represent 18,000 students, 1,200 employees, 64,000 alum. But on behalf of myself today, I want to thank each and every one of you in this room, each and every one of you, because you all know what part you play in this. And I know almost all of you that are in this room. We've shared a story together. We've shared an experience together. I want to thank every single one of you for what you continue to do to help this college be the best it can be. But most importantly, think about this. While CCRI continues to change lives and help students achieve their dreams. Thank you all for being here. Now my privilege to bring up to the podium the one and only, the Chair of the Board of Education, Attorney Eva Mancuso. Eva.
Thank you, and someday when I turn 50, I'll know how the community college feels. I'm thrilled to be here today, and thank you for asking me to participate in the college's 50th anniversary. As you know, I've been Chair of the Board of Education for the past 3 years, and we all know that we consistently fight for public higher education. CCRI has done a remarkable job. As you know, I am a lifelong Rhode Islander, and watching the college grow over the years really has been something. When this college opened in 1964 with 325 students in an old factory building, who would think that we would be where we are today? Today we're the largest community college in New England. And more importantly, I have a real soft spot for the community college. As a young prosecutor, I had an opportunity to teach a few law enforcement classes, and so I became an adjunct at the community college. And I taught in the law enforcement program for about 6 years, and then I worked with the faculty to actually work on the curriculum. So having a small little piece of the community college, most like a lot of Rhode Islanders, I think that if we had this meeting at the Rhode Island Mall today, and we asked people walking by, they would all have some kind of story. My second story, and my most favorite, is that my youngest daughter didn't know where she was going to go off to school. And unlike her brothers and sisters who had real direction, she didn't know what she wanted to do. So she started at the community college. And last year, she graduated magna cum laude from Northeastern University with that CCRI background taking her forward. So, again, as we look at the schools, our public schools in Rhode Island, CCRI not only is affordable, but it's also accessible. You know, when I talk to people about those kinds of things, professors that spend that extra minute talking to them, professors that work in the industry so they have real life experience, that's what it means to our Rhode Islanders. So President DePasquale, the faculty, fellow board members, Governor Chafee, it's a real pleasure to be here to be part of this celebration. And President DePasquale, in 50 years when I'm there opening the capsule, I'll tell them all about you. So congratulations.
It's now my pleasure to introduce the chair of the higher education side of the Board of Education, Mike Bernstein. Michael.
Thank you, Ray. I just want to maybe take a minute or two. I know we do have an outstanding speaking program. So without coming up with a formal presentation, just a couple of comments. I grew up in Providence. I went to public school starting elementary school. And I won't tell you how long ago it was. My entire family all went to public schools in Providence, my father, my mother, my sister, my Uncle Bo, my Uncle Happy, and it was just a large commitment. Now, when I was a little bit younger, once upon a time, when I was in school, we didn't have a community college. We had a couple of flagship, wonderful universities, but we also had a couple of schools that were just beginning and developing. And as I look back, and I think of some of the wonderful schoolmates I had, I sort of wish that this thing had started a long, long time ago. Because what this has meant, and what this has done for so many young people, it's given them a jump start. And you look at some of the folks in the room who started at CCRI and moved forward, some of the distinguished political elected folks and my colleagues, and you really know how much it's really meant to us. So as somebody who's seen this and lived with it right from the bottom up, this is a real wonderful day. I also want to thank Governor Chafee. It's been an interesting year on this Board of Education. And I can tell you when we started and I asked the chairperson what this was going to be like, I think your words were, we better duck. This is going to be an interesting year. So one thing about the chair, she was a woman of her word. Worked with some wonderful colleagues, saw a lot of people with different opinions, but the commitment that Rhode Island has to education, both public and private, is wonderful, and it's really kept me going, and it's kept this a real interesting year. We do have a new commissioner who is, so far has done a wonderful job. I don't want to get in trouble. As was mentioned, he came up from Louisiana, and I kept thinking if he had one of these big southern hats, Ray, I kept wondering what you look like with it, but fortunately, you've decided to stay with us and continue the wonderful work that you've done at our wonderful university. So before I get in trouble and go on, I'd like to thank you for the opportunity to speak. And again, Governor Chafee, thank you so much for the commitment that you've given us.
Thank you, Michael. Now you've heard so much about the commissioner. I guess we better get him up here. So our new commissioner of higher education, Jim Purcell.
Well, it's great to be with you all today. To talk about Community College of Rhode Island and really what community colleges do. Excuse me, I was sick the last couple days. It's really about helping people with the American dream. Thomas Jefferson said it best when he said, I was a revolutionary so that my children could farm and that their children can do art. And it's really about three generations where the American dream is possible. And the community college, I think, is really the modern go west place. Horace Greeley used to say, go west, young man, but if he was alive today, he would certainly say that education, go to college, and that's the key. So to me, Community College of Rhode Island has lived up to that legacy. Going from Providence to the west was the future, but now the future can be here. And it's all dependent on making sure our people have the skill sets necessary for this modern economy. And I know the Community College of Rhode Island has helped the last 50 years, and I look forward to seeing the successes they make with the state in the next 50. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Commissioner. Now representing our honorary chairs, a two-time alum of the Community College of Rhode Island, both in nursing, fire science, and a long-term friend. I've had the privilege every year of being the master of ceremonies for his inauguration. It is one of the most moving things anybody's ever asked me to do, and so Joe and I have become great friends. And Joe, it truly is a pleasure to be able to introduce you, representing all the cities and towns in the state of Rhode Island, as our speaker on behalf of all the mayors, Joe Polisena.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. You'll be relieved we have a four-year term now, so I won't be calling on every 2 years. But before I begin, I served 12 years here at the State House as a state senator and served under three governors. And they would all talk education, all talk education. When it came time to put the money there, they didn't. This is the only gentleman that did. This is the only gentleman that did. And I don't mean to point, Governor, but really, you did a fabulous job. You knew the importance of education, and as I said, you put the resources where they were needed, and we really appreciate that. But not only that, I think the state of Rhode Island really owes you a debt of gratitude for what you did. So I want to thank you personally. Well, I'm proud and honored and humbled to be here today to say a few words about one of our most important institutions, and that is the Community College of Rhode Island. CCRI is one of those precious gems in our great state that does so much for so many. CCRI is one of the economic engines that drives our economy, and it helps secure our future with its many programs that puts people to work and puts them into the workforce where they belong. The Community College of Rhode Island continues to strive to meet Rhode Island's needs and, of course, the needs of its citizens when it comes to education, getting people ready, and, as I said before, putting them in the workforce, which to me is the most important thing. At CCRI, they accept both young and old. They would even accept me today. other than 30 years ago when I was about 30 pounds lighter and I had black hair. That's when I was accepted as a student. But they do accept young and old, and of course they accept those who are unsure and haven't decided really what they want to do in life. You know, one's decision to enroll in CCRI, it's an important decision, and it's truly life-changing. That's why you may have heard said before at CCRI, we constantly change lives, and they really do. And I say we because I still work there. They haven't gotten rid of me yet. I work there as an adjunct. CCRI has helped retool and rebuild the job market by offering so many programs with the very best cadre of professors, instructors, as well as ancillary staff that work there. The community college has helped Rhode Islanders achieve their goals and fulfill their dreams, as well as provide for their families. With so many programs that's offered, be it a certificate or a degree, it all fits perfect in Rhode Island's economy. CCRI is well known throughout the nation for its nursing program, one of my programs I graduated from. And as I said, putting people to work, but putting the best and the brightest nurses out there and the most compassionate nurses out there. CCRI is well affordable and offers opportunities for all Rhode Islanders, regardless of their income. I think the president mentioned that earlier. Now I'll tell you a quick side story. I'll deviate from my speech. When I was 18, I got on the fire department, and before that I wanted to go to college. And my parents were very poor. My father was a truck driver, my mother was a stay-at-home mom. And they really fell back because they couldn't send me. So I was able to obviously work. I started working as a fireman at 18, very young, as I said, about 30 pounds, 40 pounds ago. Had real nice black hair. And was able to go part-time. And they catered to those people, to those men and women who worked. And that was very important to me. That's why we celebrate the 50th birthday, or anniversary, however you want to call it, of one of Rhode Island's most valuable resources. It's more than just a celebration. I think it's a milestone of accomplishments and success stories for the thousands and thousands of people who have traveled through the doors of CCRI. And I happen to be one of those success stories. If it was not for CCRI, I don't think I'd be standing where I am today. Obviously, I got my education at CCRI, and I was able to become a firefighter, retire as a battalion chief, as well as the EMS coordinator, a registered nurse, Rhode Island State Senator, assistant professor, and now mayor of Johnston. Because of CCRI, I was able to pursue my advanced degrees, and I got my bachelor's degree and my master's degree, but my foundation came from the community college. And as I said, I was very proud, and I still tell people that I'm a graduate of CCRI, and I brag about it, and I also say I'm a nurse. I may have been a senator, I may have been a fireman, but I'm a nurse, because we have one, I think, and I'm partial towards the nursing program, so I apologize for those of you here that maybe don't teach in nursing, but they have one heck of a program. So as elected officials that are here today, my colleagues in government, we have an obligation to ensure that CCRI remains strong, both academically and financially. We need to ensure that the people we represent, both young and old, as well as the citizens of our future, have the opportunity that so many of us have had, thanks to the Community College of Rhode Island. As elected leaders here today, we must be a strong voice to our state, to our state leaders, and to our General Assembly, and of course the federal delegation, to ensure that CCRI stays strong, be it financial support, as well as the support of our elected officials, maybe coming around visiting once in a while would be great. So from all of us, to the faculty and staff, as well as President Ray DePasquale and the students, we wish you a great 50th year celebration slash birthday, and we'll have many, many more successes. God bless CCRI. Thank you.
Thank you, Mayor. Obviously, one of the most important things is 64,000 students have gone through the halls of our college. Our current students who are here make me smile every day when you see them in the halls, and they talk about their stories and what they want to be and where they want to go, and they know they're getting a quality education. And all of you are here to support those students, because that's what we're about. It's about providing education for the young people. And remember, it is Rhode Island's community college, where 98% of our students come from Rhode Island, and they stay in Rhode Island, and they work in Rhode Island, and they bring up their families here, and they help make this economy strong. So representing all of that with no pressure whatsoever is a member of the first graduating class some 50 years ago. Wow. I know. Representing the first graduating class and representing all that CCRI represents in terms of its students, the honorary chair, co-chair of the 50th anniversary, Sondra Pitts.
Thank you. I am very humbled to have been asked to represent my class today. And I was asked to speak briefly about the contrast between how it was when we entered and now. This magnificent building was so important in the early history of the Community College of Rhode Island. It was here 50 years ago that a visionary governor and visionary members of the General Assembly designed the foundation of this college. It was from here, at lunchtime, that John Chafee, that visionary governor, would walk the short distance to the CIC building to check on how the college was doing. It was here on the steps of this building that members of CCRI's first graduating class, my class, received their associate's degrees. I love this building. My class began with 325 students selected from a pool of 800. Most of us were just out of high school, and all of us were full-time. In the fall of 1965, we were joined by an incoming class of 900, causing the college to balloon in size so much that it had to expand into converted factory space. Almost overnight, our classrooms were joined by laboratories, a library, a cafeteria, and a student activity center. My class and classes behind us were challenged, inspired, and nurtured by CCRI's founding president, Dr. William Flanagan, and its unmatched faculty and staff. With their encouragement, we organized a college senate, a newspaper, a literary magazine, a basketball team, cheerleaders, a drama group, a band and glee club, a chamber of commerce club, and a student service organization. Our graduating class had a class ring, a yearbook, an alma mater, and a prom. It is no wonder that the Providence Journal christened our college the Miracle on Promenade Street. Through the prism of CCRI today, those first two pioneering years may strike us as quaint, for CCRI has a credit enrollment this semester of more than 17,500. This year, it is likely to train or provide non-credit programs for more than 30,000. The few hundred graduates from those first 2 years have been joined by more than 64,000 others. And those makeshift facilities in downtown Providence have been transformed into four campuses and two satellite locations across the state. So CCRI's inspired beginnings have been followed by five decades of growth and success, responding to changes in its environment and to new expectations for it without abandoning its identity as an institution of higher education. With the support of the people of Rhode Island, we will extend this record of achievement for another 50 years and beyond. My 50th anniversary co-chairs are Marianne and Jack Renza and my husband, Tom. Please join us in a year-long celebration of this important milestone in the history of the largest degree-granting community college in New England, the Community College of Rhode Island.
As we bring this ceremony to an end, I want to thank each and every one of you for coming today. It really means a lot to see your faces, to see you here celebrating, because I hope when you walk out of here today, you'll feel like we all do, that we have so much more to do. We have so many more students to help educate. We have so much more to do to help our state get stronger and better, and the community college wants to lead that way. As we give our congratulations to the new governor-elect, Gina Raimondo, we pledge our support, we pledge our help, our excitement, and our energy, along with the Board of Education, that we're going to do great things for the state of Rhode Island. But that doesn't come without someone leaving the legacy that he has. And Governor Chafee, today, I want to personally thank you. As a member of your cabinet for almost 3.5 years, it was a privilege to serve with you. Learned a lot from you, and I learned how to be a better leader. And on behalf of the entire state, and on behalf of the Community College of Rhode Island, we, each and every one of us in this room, our 18,000 students, our 64,000 alum, our 1,200 employees, and me as president of this college, I want to thank you for declaring this Community College of Rhode Island Day in the state of Rhode Island. Governor Chafee, thank you and thank you.